Welcome to LoadRunner Tutorial 10, Controller Goal-Oriented Scenario. In this video, we will learn about the goal-oriented scenario in Controller. Now here we have the performance requirement examples that we saw earlier. One requirement is that 15 users can book their flights simultaneously in the HP WebTours web application. So let us see how we can implement a goal-oriented scenario in Controller. Now I already have Controller open. In order to create a new goal-oriented scenario, we can click on File, New, and make sure that goal-oriented scenario is selected. Then we can add one or more of our LoadRunner scripts to the scenario and click on the OK button. First, we need to set up the load generators. In order to do that, click on the generators button and we can add the load generators by using the add button or add the load generators from the cloud. It is possible that the controller runs on a different machine and the load is put from different load generator machines. I'm going to click on add and add my local computer as a load generator. So put localhost and click on OK. Now the status is being shown as down, so let me make sure that this load generator is available by clicking on the connect button. So now it is showing as ready and I can close the load generators dialog box. Next, in order to set up the goal oriented scenario, click on edit scenario goal button. Now here we have to specify the goal profile name. Now we can rename it, so I'm going to call it VU15 because I want to test with 15 virtual users. There are 5 types of goals in the controller goal oriented scenario, and here we can choose our goal type. It can be virtual users or hits per second or transactions per second, the transaction response time or pages per minute. Hits per second and pages per minute are applicable for web applications. I'm going to select virtual users, and the goal is that 15 virtual users should be able to log into the application and use it. Next, we have to specify the runtime, which is a time it should run after the target has been achieved. So I'm going to change it to 1 minute. And if the target cannot be reached, there are a couple of options. One is to stop the scenario and save the results because I don't want to spend any more time. Or we can also continue the scenario without reaching the goal. If we select this option, it basically continues for some time even after it decides that LoadRunner cannot reach that particular goal. So click on OK and click on the start scenario button. I've already started the HP WebTours web server. If this is not started, then the scenario will fail immediately because the web server itself is not running. So now we can see that LoadRunner has started loading the users and it has already loaded 15 virtual users and they are all in the run state right now. So as we can see, in a goal oriented scenario, we specified the goal, we specified how many V users should be run, and LoadRunner created the scenario automatically. When the scenario is running, we can still see its details. We can see the goal profile name. Here we can see the goal type we selected as virtual users. We wanted LoadRunner to reach a goal of 15 virtual users. It is going to run the scenario 1 minute after the target has been achieved. So here we can see the data is started coming in. In the scenario groups, we can see that 15 V users are running, and in the scenario status pane, we can see the other information. Now the scenario is passed because LoadRunner has stopped the scenario. So this is how we can set up a goal-oriented scenario. Let us set up another goal-oriented scenario, and this time we'll set it up for the transactions per second. So let us click on Edit Scenario Goal, and I'm going to call it TPS 0.5 because I want to test whether it is possible to have 0.5 transactions per second, and the goal type is going to be transactions per second. I wanted to reach a goal of 0.5 transactions per second using a minimum of one virtual user and a maximum of 15 virtual users, and rest of the settings I'll keep as the same. Run for 1 minute after target has been achieved, and if target cannot be reached, stop scenario and save the results and click on OK and click on Start Scenario. So the minimum number of V users was 1, so that is what is being run right now. And here we have the graphs: running V users, transaction response time, hits per second. And instead of Windows resources, I want to put transactions per second. We can go back to the design, and we can see that the transaction that we have selected is the home page transaction. We can select another transaction also, but this is fine. It has to be a transaction which is implemented in the vUser script. Now the data is started coming in, and here we can see that it is meeting an average of 0.022 transactions per second, and our goal is 0.5 transactions per second. So LoadRunner will automatically adjust the load. It can increase the number of vUsers anywhere between 1 to 15 vUsers. It can get rid of the think time that we have implemented, and basically LoadRunner will manage these settings automatically in order to meet the target that we have specified for transactions per second. In the meantime, we can look at the scenario. So here the goal profile name is transactions per second 0.5. The goal type we have selected is transactions per second. The transaction that we are measuring is to look at the home page. We wanted to reach a goal of 0.5 transactions per second. And here we get the error: the target you defined cannot be reached. So this is what happens when LoadRunner is unable to reach the target that we have specified. So this means it is not able to meet this particular requirement. Let us change our scenario now. Again, click on Edit Scenario Goal, and this time I'm going to select a different transaction, for example search flight, and give it a smaller goal, maybe 0.3 transactions per second, and click on OK and start the scenario. So again the scenario has started. And in scenario we can see transaction name is search flight. So let us see the data of that. This is that transaction. Now LoadRunner is going to reach that target, attempt to reach that target, and soon we'll know whether it is able to reach that target or not. So if it is a performance requirement and LoadRunner is unable to reach the target, that means we have to go back to the application and make changes to the application or make changes to the server hardware, so that then we run the scenario again, then LoadRunner is able to meet that performance requirement. So here we are getting 0.178 transactions per second, and our target is 0.3 transactions per second, because that is the goal type that we have specified. Right now it is running just one Vusers, and LoadRunner has the option of increasing the number of Vusers or getting rid of think time or changing other settings in order to reach that target. This time it seems that it is about to reach the target, because the last value we can see is coming as 0.3 transactions per second, and here also it is about 0.3 transactions per second. LoadRunner has also increased the number of Vusers to 2. Earlier it was 1 Vuser and now it is 2 Vusers. So let us see what happens. Controller can take some time in order to reach the target or decide whether it will never be able to reach the target. So we cannot predict in advance how much time the scenario execution of goal-oriented scenario will last. So this is about the controller's goal-oriented scenario, which is different from the manual scenario we can also set up in controller. So in summary, we can say that in a goal-oriented scenario, we specify the goal and LoadRunner creates a scenario based on the goal automatically. There are 5 types of goals that we can give: number of required Vusers, transactions per second, and for web applications, pages per minute or hits per second, or we can specify the transaction response time. So that is all for this video, and see you in the next video. Thanks.